Sent to Earth to destroy us. For Christ's sake, shoot!
I understand. Did your husband say anything before he disappeared? Did he leave a note or something?
No. He left the house without a word, and there was just the cell phone.
You have not reached your destination.
Sir, are you all right? I'll call an ambulance.
No ambulance.
You're badly hurt. You need a doctor.
Please, just help me to my room. It's number 207.
This time it looks like we got our origami killer.
Are we partners?
We're partners.
Very well. I'm the origami killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on their chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown!
Whoa!
Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. Dead end. I'm gonna die in here if I don't find a way out soon. What's that noise? Rats. Charming. If they got in, then maybe I can get out. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. Yeah. I guess I don't really have any choice.
Oh my god. Ethan. Ethan, can you hear me?
You've got a hell of a fever. Clothes off to disinfect those wounds. Look really bad. I need to disinfect your wounds. Doctor, but I'll do what I can. Sorry. I'll go easier. Your wounds are disinfected. Sorry, I'm stupid. I'm using anti-burn ointments on your cuts. He's unconscious. Now I'll just have to wait. And hope he wakes up. How do you feel?
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel Act? You don't even know me.
You didn't really leave me any choice. I couldn't just leave you like that.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. The kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but it's not easy. You mixed up with the mafia? Owe someone money? Something like that?
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me. You've already done a lot, Madison.
Right. I'm gonna go. Take care.
I didn't do it. I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no. Then why did you run away when they came to question you?
I already told you. I forgot to report to my parole officer. I didn't want to go back to prison. When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
We checked out his statement. He has an alibi for at least 3 of the murders.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
Ash? Okay. Sean Moss's mother's here. She'd like to speak with you.
It was a few months back, the middle of the night. It was pouring down. Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been. He spoke about drowning the rain. He didn't make any sense. There was something. Something in his eyes. As if it wasn't really him. There may be no connection. But the next day, there was that announcement about another victim of the origami killer. Find my son. I'm begging you.
Police Lieutenant Carter Blake, and this is Agent Norman Jaden of the FBI. According to our information, Ethan Mars is one of your patients. We'd like to ask you a few questions about him.
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
I beg your pardon?
I'm bound by an oath of secrecy. Under no circumstances may I discuss my patients.
My job is to find Sean Mars alive, and I don't give a damn about any bullshit oath.
It's your duty to inform the police if you suspect one of your patients, Doctor.
I'm sorry. I can't help you. And now I must ask you to leave.
You need to cooperate. For your own sake.
Doctor, a child's life is at stake. You may know something that could help us save him.
Are you threatening me?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc. I suggest you take it.
I know you don't want to protect a murderer. If you know anything, you must tell us, Doctor.
I am going to call the police and make a complaint about your behavior.
Doctor, you are really pushing my buttons. The only thing I'm interested in is saving that kid's life. So, you're going to be a good boy and tell me what I want to know, or I am really going to lose my temper.
Blake, that's enough. Let's get out of here.
Let go of me. You have no right.
Come on, Doc. There's an easy way and a hard way. It's your fucking choice. What's up with you, Norm? Are you getting cold feet? You don't like to get your hands dirty, huh? I thought you wanted to save that kid!
I want to save Sean Mars just as much as you do, but that doesn't give me the freedom to do what the hell I like, so you're gonna stop this shit right now!
I'll get you for this, Jaden. Don't worry. I will not forget.
Ethan Mars has had psychological problems since his first son died. Feels responsible for his death. A sort of morbid neurosis. He is haunted by visions of drowning bodies. A few weeks ago, after one of our usual sessions, I found this on the floor. It must have fallen out of his pocket.
Ash, I want you to assign every available man to finding Ethan Mars. I want a man outside his place day and night. Notify all agencies to start looking for him. I want you to keep an eye on the train stations, the airports, the bus terminals. I want every cop in the city on his ass, so that if he moves, we know about it. Yes, Ethan Mars is the origami killer.
Nice shot.
Thank you. Please come in, Mr. Shelby. Would you care for a coffee?
Oh, no thanks.
Do you play?
I tried once, but I think the owner of the course is still looking for me.
It's an interesting sport. It requires strength, but also a cool head and absolute precision. Would you care to hit a few balls with me? There's no danger of damaging the greens here.
Okay.
Take off your jacket and grab a club. The balls are in that basket. The most important thing is to grip the club correctly. When you feel ready, you swing. Hell, it's only your first ball. You should try to strike it a little harder next time.
I'm assuming you didn't invite me here just to play golf, Mr. Kramer.
I hear you've been asking questions about my son.
That's right. I want to know if Gordy is linked to the Origami Killer case in any way.
My son had nothing to do with that sordid case.
Well, then he has nothing to fear from my investigation.
You have no business investigating my son. I told you, he had nothing to do with it.
With all due respect, Mr. Kramer, it's up to me to decide who I want to investigate.
I'm an influential man, Mr. Shelby, and I pay very well.
Are you trying to buy me?
Let's just say I'm trying to show you where your interest lies. How much do you want to leave my son alone?
I think you misunderstood me. I don't play that game.
Don't go near my son, Mr. Shelby. If you do, you'll regret it.
Have a nice day, Mr. Kramer.
Porcelain lizards? They look new. Out of place with the rest of this old beat-up stuff.
Are you prepared to suffer to save your son? You have 5 minutes to cut off the last section of one of your fingers in front of the camera. If you succeed, you will get your reward. Under the desk.
Ah. That's affirmative, Lieutenant. We're in position.
Perfect. Nobody moves until I give this signal. Is that clear? We nail him as soon as he sets foot outside.
Right, Lieutenant.
Lucky that patrol spotted his car.
What's he doing in there?
Beats me. You're the profiler, right? I thought you were supposed to be right inside the killer's head.
Well, that's just it. What I know of Ethan Mars doesn't match the killer's psychological profile.
I know what the jury's gonna choose between your theories and concrete proof. What the fuck is that girl doing there? If Mars comes out now, she's gonna be in trouble.
What do we do, Lieutenant? Wanna get her out?
No, stand down. Going inside. Maybe she lives there. Us just as well. We don't want anyone hanging around if Mars comes out.
Ethan, what happened? The police. They're out there. I think they're here to arrest you. We've got to find another way out.
Shit. What's he up to in there? Wait for a go on my word.
They're still out there. We've got to find another way.
Ready on my go. Stay here, Jayden.
Out of the question. I'm coming with you.
Two men at the door, hold your positions. It's a go.
Come on, let's go this way.
Downstairs. They're in the alley. Follow them.
The subway.
going. Ethan! Ethan, they're coming!
Chance.